Ladies, 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 want the finest in hair care services? Then come to Diva Hair in Pond Extension Basseterre. We do nails, relaxers, weaves, haircuts, customs wig, color, hair treatment, lashes, and so much more. Our salon is clean and comfortable even while you wait. We take appointments only. Opened on Mondays and Tuesdays at 10 a.m. with the last appointment at 5 p.m., Thursdays and Fridays at 9 a.m. to 6 p.m., and Saturdays at 6 a.m. to 3 p.m. To make appointments, visit our Facebook page, Diva Hair. Call us at 660-4884. Diva Hair in Pond Extension for the beauty in you.
Hobson Enterprises' Garden Hotspurs has shot up the top of the SKNFA National Bank Premier League table after edging Sol Island Auto Connery FC 1-0 on Sunday at the Warner Park. Alexis Sadler scored in the 81st minute after both teams tussled for much of the match to get the opening goal. It was a tense battle, especially in the second half, mixed with hard tackles, rough play and counter-attacking football. Connery had the better of the chances but failed to put them away or to test the goalkeeper, who incidentally is a former Connery player. The intensity of the game even led to a red card for Connery after Ahijah Wilkes ran off the bench to engage Hotspur's players in a skirmish close to the sidelines. He was immediately sent to the locker room. Coach Sinclair Morris of Garden Hotspurs said he urged his players to defend well and pressure the Connery defence, which was key to their victory.
It was a test for the for Spurs because we played three games in nine days, and that's a very accomplishment. We win two and draw one. At least we are at the top of the tables now, so they give us an extra boost to go forward.
What do you manage? Because you did manage to frustrate Connery. They had good opportunities, probably better than what you had, but yet they weren't able to put them away. What would you credit that to?
Well, at halftime, we told the players that we were battling the factors of the rain and also the refereeing. So we tell them that this is our time. And the second half is going to be our half, so we should pressure them all the time. And that's what we did. We were pressuring Connery all the time, and that's how we get a win. We were patient with it. And then, at the end of the day, we get 3 points.
Now, what do you think now, considering that you're at the top of the table now, this puts added pressure on you because you have more pressure when you're at the top than when you're trying to go up to the top. How would you handle that?
Well, being at the top of the table doesn't matter. We just take each game one at a time. Our next game is Trinity. It should be a light game, but I don't think we're going to take it like that.
For coach Alexis Morris of Connery, his team lacked concentration throughout the entire duration of the match, which is something they have to work on for their upcoming matches.
Well, say thanks to my guys coming out and playing a good game up to the point when Spurs would have scored the goal. I think my guys was really ready for this game, and I think we lost the way we won one play, and three mistakes within one play. And I think what we need to do is basically concentrate to the end. And just like we did last week, we come back the same way this week, and we lapse in concentration, especially in the dying moments again. When we have teams on the back foot, we definitely have to put them away. We had some good opportunities, but just up to the last night, we would have practiced trying to get the shot from the red zone. I think we would have had a number of opportunities which we squandered. I think just having guys being on the same page throughout the game really would have cost us again. But like I said, we have a lot to build in, and we just have to keep the guys motivated and come and prepare, to play games week after week. We see where we went wrong, and we definitely just need to work on it.
Results in other matches in Sunday's triple header saw Fancast Saddlers drawing 1-1 with Rams Village Superstars. Curvey Jarvis scored for Saddlers in the 64th minute, but Tahir Hanley of Village equalized in the 74th minute. In the earlier match of the day, Flo 4G Cairn Rockets crushed St. Thomas Trinity United 4-0. Carlos Bertie scored a hat-trick for Cairn in the 61st, 80th and 90th minute, and Shaquille Pringle scored in the 79th minute. So after this weekend of results, the point standings after round 2 see Hobson Enterprises Garden Hotspurs at the top of the table with 26 points, Rams Village Superstars in second place just down by a point with 25 points, SL Horses St. Paul's remain unbeaten in the league with 24 points in third place, Flo 4G Cairn Rockets on 20 points in fourth place, Sol Island Auto Supplies Connery FC, they fall to fifth with 18 points, Winners Circle Newtown United on 14 points in sixth place, Elko Limited St. Peter's on 7th, also on 14 points, but down by goal difference. Fast Cash Saddlers, they are on 10 points in 8th. 9th place, see St. Thomas Trinity United on 7 points, and TGE Diabe Eagles at the bottom of the table with 6 points.